everyone, and welcome. Today, I wanted to show you two products that I purchased that were fails. the first, they're both from Honeylove. Honeylove, H-O-N-E-Y-L-O-V-E, Honeylove. Now, I'm not necessarily new to shapewear, which I'll go into that in a little bit. I have some shapewear from, Spanx, and I like it. But to be honest with you, like, it's the shapewear that has the shoulder straps, and I've never, this might be TMI, but I've never been successful when going to the restroom wearing that. So I wanted to buy something that was black, because the one that I have is nude, and I really like that one though. It does a good job at keeping you in. But I also wanted something that I could pull down, so I was looking around other companies, and I may still try some of the other ones, but for some reason I was drawn to Honeylove. Now, the first product that was the Super Power Short, and it features stand tall, soft flex structures, support posture, targeted compression, tones and smooths, stays up, soft flex boning, reliable, prevents rolling down, and made in a certified responsible facility. Designed in California. Like I said, this is Super Power Short from Honeylove Sculptwear. Now, I believe I wear a small. Maybe I don't. Maybe that's where I messed up, because I thought I was a small. I don't know what possessed me to think that I was a small. But let's just say I could not put these on. They're way too small, so apparently I'm a medium. But I did want to show them to you anyway. Now, I'm not going to keep these, okay? I'm going to return them. And I'll list out the items that I'm going to get instead. But I figured this, I could at least show you this. Now, this is a very interesting material. It feels fine. But it does have some, I don't know if you can tell here in the camera, I hope you can, it has some boning, you can see it there, and I'm assuming it's plastic, but I was really afraid I was going to break it when I was trying to put it on, because this body suit or whatever, it would not go up on my behind. I'm just going to be honest, it just didn't. And I suspect that was my fault. But the boning, I didn't necessarily feel was my thing. And maybe it would help me with my posture, which I do need help with, but I'm not quite sure. It does, this one, I don't think it has the X, Honeylove is, it has like a band, like an X band that goes across the bodysuit, okay? It goes like this, and it's supposed to help tighten. Plus, the back is supposed to give you like, help with posture. And it's kind of like a corset. You know how the corsets have that boning? And then it also has, I mean, it's well constructed, I'll give it that. It has more of a see-through mesh on the front, and then also like on the sides of the bottom of your bottom, it has some clear, almost like, so it doesn't pinch you, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, so these were $89, and I'm gonna go ahead and read the description. Targeted compression sculpts without squeezing, flexible boning prevents roll down, and breathable fabric keeps you cool. Okay, I could do with something thicker and do compression at the same time. part of living with those illnesses. So compression garments come in handy for me sometimes, not all the time. Sometimes I can wear, you know, like, plus it just gives you a smoother look anyway, so from an aesthetic standpoint, like, why wouldn't you? Especially if I'm gonna film, or if I'm gonna wear something that's like form-fitting, right? I want to make sure that I look good and shape warehouse with that. So that was my reasoning. Now, in all fairness, I am interested in possibly getting a medium one. And here's the Honeylove logo. But instead, I decided to, let me see if I can, where is it? Let me find it really quick. I should have just said it. I just decided to go for the mid-waist short, which is, let's see, targeted X compression. It's together. It's not, as all of you know, I'm sure, it's not easy to find a bra that fits well. And so my bra size is a 32 triple D. Okay, and it's difficult to find a bra that fits your body around. And then with a cup that's large enough and doesn't misshape your breast, if that makes sense. When you have natural boobs, and by the way, my boobs are natural, I feel like when you have natural boobs, how do I say this tactfully? It's when you have fake boobs, right? They kind of just hold that shape. Because you essentially have like a bag of, you know, of liquid that has a shape. When you have natural breasts, obviously natural breasts have a shape, but I feel like they're more moldable, if that makes sense. And let me know if I'm the only one that experiences this. Maybe I'm just wearing the wrong bra, I don't know. But I find that I prefer the shape that an underwire provides, okay? And I think the reason that is because it kind of helps, you know, form the breast or shape it. Not too drastically, obviously, but it helps kind of give more of a voluminous, if you will, shape. What I find is sometimes these types of bras give you a more squished look. That's my opinion. And I don't particularly like that. Not that I necessarily want to show off my breasts, but I want them to look the best that they can. So, that's why I personally prefer underwire for those times that I'm gonna go out and do a nice, for those times that I wanna look good, you know, where I want everything to look on point, basically. And so that's my kind of, that's my complaint with bras that don't have an underwire. Now, don't get me wrong, the technology has definitely improved. We've gone a long way. But again, I still prefer the underwire bras because they do give you more of a, you know, more of a proper shape that I'm used to anyway. Now, obviously, you know, I'm in my 40s. I grew up in the era where, like, Victoria's Secret kind of showed you what you're supposed to look like. But I do like that shape, I'm not gonna lie. I like that kind of that defined shape, if you will. That's what I like. Even though these are very, very comfortable, I don't mind a bra with an underwire at all. Having said that, you know, if I need another bra, I may give this one a shot. But again, I'm not in the market. I thought this was really gonna be just like amazingly awesome and revolutionary, and it wasn't. It wasn't what I thought. So instead, I decided to go with this. What is it? This lift wear tank. Now the lift wear tank comes in an extra small, small, medium, large, extra large, 1X, 2X, and 3X. And this one I think was $89 as well, I think. Anyway, so reason I decided to go with that tank instead of something else was because all of the tanks that I have are super old and don't look really nice, so I figured I would buy a nice tank and then you know, so that I can have to wear. Now the tank is $84. Let's see what some other reviews read. So much for watching my video, and I'll die.